And now I'm talking to a young woman who's over $100,000 in debt about how student loans are affecting her plans for the future. Here's our conversation.
Well, I just checked right before this interview. I'm sitting at about $103,000 in student debt. There was no other choice. It was either take the loans out or don't go to school. So I knew I had to go to school in order to reach my goals. I fight myself on it a lot simply because I'm not where I want to be right now. If I could have it my way, I would already be in medical school, but you know, sometimes life doesn't go the way that you plan it to go.
Thank you so much for being willing to share your story. Let's just talk about, how did you get into debt? What dream were you going after?
I want to be a physician. So the only way I could get to that goal is to go through undergrad. And I know that that can happen, you know, without student loans, because I don't have $103,000 or $60,000 at hand to just pay for school right out of pocket.
So you knew you wanted to be a doctor, and that's amazing, because we need more Black women and men, okay, in the STEM field. But then when you start to go after the dream, when does it become clear that, you know what, I'm going to have to take loans out?
When I started applying to college my senior year, I'm like, I don't even have any type of money to put towards it at all. Like, everything was completely school loans. I had family members helping out, you know, getting me ready for, you know, your freshman year moving in, things you need for your dorm. But outside of that, I had no college fund at all.
Again, when you're a student, it's like, you're not working yet necessarily,
Exactly. Or
you're not done. So you are trying to get your education. But when you get out and then it hits you that you have to start paying it back, then it becomes real. What is the effect on you emotionally, knowing that you have this amount of debt?
Emotionally, it gives me anxiety every time I think about it. I guess we'll see when the time comes, but every time I think about it, I get worried, because I'm like, how am I going to be able to afford that and my personal bills at the same time?
That what you described right there, literally studies have been done about that. And they say that this disproportionately impacts Black people. So we tend to have more pressure to gotta take a job, right? Got bills to pay. You don't really have the luxury of, you know, doing a free internship or doing a $15 an hour job to go after maybe the larger dream that you have. It's so interesting. It's like a domino effect. All you were trying to do was go after your dream, and now you have to walk this perfect tightrope, right?
Exactly.
You know, I'm curious how you feel about the racial inequity that's tied to this, because when you look at the numbers, Black families tend to have smaller net worth, right? And so things like student loans really can set you back, whereas white families tend to have more, so they have that cushion. What do you think about that inequality?
It's upsetting to think about, because I, even for myself, I feel like if I was able to pay for college outright, I might be in a different predicament. I wouldn't have had to have taken the internships that I did, because, you know, a lot of those were income-based, people with low socioeconomic status. I would have probably been able to get into better programs, have like a better college experience due to the resources if I had funding, period.
As we wrap up this conversation, I just want to give you the floor to talk directly to the Biden-Harris administration. They're sitting around a room right now trying to decide, do we cancel the student loan debt? Do we write the executive order and sign it? What are you going to tell them?
I would tell them to erase it completely, because it affects people with low socioeconomic status greatly. It affects people of color greatly, because as we talked before, it's a domino effect. If you don't pay your student loans, it's going to mess your credit up. You can't rent, you can't get cars, you can't get credit cards. It just messes you up completely. And I feel like if we can donate billions to other countries, we can take care of our people first. That's what I would tell them.